Hello everybody, welcome back to Scratch for Fun, and today we are doing a little bit more programming, continuing our work at the pipe. This is a pre-recorded kind of episode, that's why it's only been the pipe at the moment. We are of course going to move back to the windmill, and of course continue the pipe series once that's kind of moving along. At the moment we are going to basically draw out the connectors here. We're just going to draw some pixels up, and then we are going to, it's only four sides so it should be quick, and then we are going to rotate it around all of the edges. That's probably all we have time for in this episode though. I'm probably going to move on to the straight one as well, actually, while I think of it. So let's jump into the connector thing here, sorry, and we're going to start drawing. Now let's do this, copy this right here for easy measure. Now we're going to start to draw at this point right here. Now of course I don't know which way this is kind of going to face, I guess, so it's going to be a little bit random, if it's like this way, this way, this way, or this way, but we're going to make it. So let's start at this point right here. Might be any other point, but let's fictionally say this point right here, which is basically a little bit over the ground here. So starting at 1 minus, then it moves over to 1 whole pixel in Y here, we're calculating Y, continues along the 1 whole pixel, and then 1 minus again at the end. So what we're basically seeing right now is we are saying, yeah, here we go. So this is basically the position we are drawing at. So it starts right here, then it draws up here. Now this is the same height as a block right here, one float, moves along and down again. Okay, now the textures are a little bit different here. Instead of saying 5x5, we can see here, this is basically the texture right here, 5x5 here. We're going to start off by drawing down here, which is 10x5. So the width, we're going to boost all of the width stuff by 5, so here, 10, instead of 0 is a 5, and instead of 0 is a 5. We basically move this along 5 pixels in the width. Very simple. If you don't get it, pause the video and yeah, do that stuff. So as you can see, it does kind of draw a little bit weird here. We should probably not have started in the corner down here. Let's actually start right here instead. So that is currently 5x5, and then we are going to draw from the X is going to be 10, the Y is going to be 5, and then we're going to have the X still at 10, the Y at 5, no, at 0, sorry, and then the X is going to be changed down to 5, this one is going to go down to 0, or still stay at 0, and as you can see the pipe is kind of moving upwards. Of course we're going to fix the back stuff later on here. Let's just make sure that we're able to draw all of this stuff. We still need, of course, a fixed block bounce, stuff like that. Let's draw this at another side here. Copy this over. Let's just quickly take the other side. So if we mirror all of the sentences in this code, and then fix up so that the texture matches the one above here, we are going to have a good... We are going to have this mirrored. What we can do is we can move this over right here. Of course we changed the textures as well, so it has to be kind of over here, because this one is like a darker kind of purple. This one is darker purple. If we were to like mirror it normally, the dark purple and the dark purple kind of would be at the same position. So we are moving it over. That's why we're moving the Y as well. So let's move Y. That's why we're changing the textures as well. Let's move this over. I think that's the set. I believe so. No, it's not. This is weird. Weird. Oh yeah. Oh, these are one. I thought I got so confused there for a moment because it wasn't giving any, making any sense at all. So it says 1 minus. Then here it says 1 minus. Do note that this is like Y, so this right here is set. And then set, and then set. So it's a little bit different distance between these two sets right here. So it might confuse you a little bit, but yeah, just as long as you get those two edges as well. Now let's draw another edge here, another side rather. What we're going to say is we're going to start off at this position right here, 11 pixels, and then we are going to move, not move, we're going to say stay at 11 pixels, then we're going to change it to 1 minus, stay at 1 minus. The Y is not going to change anything at all. The X, though, is going to stay, I think it's 1 minus, I'm not quite sure. Yeah, it is 1 minus. As you can see, we've drawn all of these three sides right here. I don't care about the texture slack over here. You feel free to change that around. I think it looks a little bit cool as it is right now. It can connect them, of course. All you need to do is, like, change around the textures for this one and the other side here. So copy this over. And then we are going to mirror this one. So here we go, mirrored. Save that. And that's not now that one right there. Let's move this side over down here. To do that, just change the X to 11 multiplied by pixel divided by 2. And now you should have... Yeah, and we need to fix the texture as well, because I think it looks a little bit weird looking like this. You might think that looks a little bit cooler. I don't enjoy it too much, I guess. I like it looking a little bit shabby in the edges. So make sure that the textures here match the textures here. So I'm changing it around a little bit, so here's this 5-0. That means that this needs to say 5-0 as well. So now it should be how I like it. So yeah, now that's basically drawing the connector up. How are we going to do this if we want to draw the connector down, for example? Let's say there was a pipe under here, and we want to draw the connector down. Now, of course, that's going to change the connectors on all of these, as you see. All of them are drawn up as well. But of course, we're going to change around that later. We're just trying to, like, do all this stuff. So, if we change this to down, there we go. That basically means that we want this thing right here to be at the bottom of the block. Of course, we can have multiple at the same time. That's kind of the whole point here. So let's say else, if the direction is equal to down, then we want to rotate it around kind of this point right here. Of course, it's around this point right here. So first of all, we need to translate this a little bit. So gl11.gl translate. Let's say float, because I like floats. 0.5 float, 0.5 float, and then 0.5 float. So what we're basically doing now is we are moving into the middle of the block before we are rotating. Now, doing this, make sure you do move it back again. It's very important. So minus 0.5, minus 0.5, and minus 0.5. What we're basically doing now is we are moving probably from like a corner up here. This corner of the block, we're moving into the middle of the block, then we're rotating the block from the middle, and then we're moving the point back up. Okay? Beautiful. So let's rotate this. So gl11.gl_gl, and then rotate. Let's rotate it around F, because it like floats more than doubles. I'm not sure why. It's kind of the same, only I think doubles might have more values. I'm not quite sure. It doesn't really matter. In our work right here, it's basically the same. So let's rotate it around 180 degrees. X0. Let's actually say X1, Y0, and Z0. And that should make sure that it gets removed. Now, do note that after you have moved it back, make sure to rotate it back again, I think. How does that work? I think... just wait a second. But yeah, my bad. We have to do this inside of the tessellator, I think. So let's jump in here inside of the tessellator and do this GL magic in here instead. It is still kind of rotating a little bit weird. It doesn't work on this. It does work on that one. All of the other ones are rotated wrong. I'm looking at my source code here, and I didn't do anything different, though. Oh yeah, I do rotate it back, actually. In the I do rotate it back working at the things here. So let's just take this one right here. Oh, and we're going to copy it down to the bottom before we end. No, after, sorry, after we have drawn, because, you know, or not, we're not going to like get the changes. So after we've drawn, let's rotate it back. The only thing you're going to change is the direction here, okay? Beautiful. That should work. Yeah, there you go. All of the pipes are back where they are supposed to be, and it's drawing down. If we jump down to this level right here, you can see it kind of touches the ground, though it is kind of half in over 2 pixels here. The reason for that, of course, is because this is 5 wide, and a normal block is 16. So now we can draw it up, we can draw it down. Let's try to draw this north. Now that is this direction over here. So what we can do, it faces up right here, so we can move it around. That's the X right there. Move it around the X, probably 90 degrees. So X 90. Save. Let's make sure we do this at the end here as well. Negative 90. Save that. And let's, snap. We have to go up here, change this to north. Let's see. No, this is south. Yeah, that's south. So let's, and we know that this is south, so we can copy and paste this. Just change this to south. If this is north, change to 270. Cover this right here as well. Negative 270. There we go. And change negative 90 to south. So now it should point against north, right here. If we say south, it should point. Let's just grab south. It should point towards this right here. We can, of course, draw multiple of these. So draw connector 2 times. South and up, for example. That draws over those 2 edges. Oh. If I say up and down, it's going to draw like so, and we can place these on top of each other, and it looks like we have a big pipe system. Of course, we do need to draw the insides of these stuff. This stuff right here does look a little bit weird, like it is now. Just need to fix that. But let's make sure we kind of get all of the edges here. So let's remove that one. Let's say to the west, for example, to the west. Now, which direction is the west, so I can like do my calculations. That's the west right there. That is probably west. That's probably around the set 90 degrees. Might be 270, who knows. Let's make sure to rotate it back, though. West negative 90 degrees. So yeah, that's correct. West. We did say west up here. Yes, we said west up there. So it's around west. Now, let's change this to east as well. And then we have all of the 6 rotations. So the east is 270. Let's copy this down here. Negative 270. And if we jump up and say east here, it should draw the connector to the east. Now, this, by the way, this is probably a bad way to do this, but it works. It is going to look beautiful in the end, so I'm not concerned. Now, we need to kind of hook all of these up together, okay? Because, you know, we want all of these to kind of, again, hook together. So, what we are going to have to do, what I did is I kind of made my own like API for all of this stuff. We are not going to do that because we are lazy people. And by the way, we're not going to work this in with microblocks because I'm lazy again. Lazy. I might do a tutorial on microblocks later on. Right now I'm like really bad on time schedule here. But as you see right now, they are all pointing this direction here. We need to kind of figure out so that they can kind of get their own direction by themselves. So in our tile entity pipe here, what we're going to do is we're going to say public forge direction array and call it connections, set it equal to a new forge direction array, set the size to 6, okay? So what we're basically, what we just did is we just said, these are all the connections. You have up, down, north, south, east, and west. It's either null or it's one of those. Take it or leave it. Let's terminate this right here while we make the other stuff. While we're at it, let's just create a constructor. I'm not sure if we're going to use it at the moment, but just so we don't have to, restart the game all the time, let's just have the constructor there. Then we have public void update entity. This right here should update our entity. Make sure you have the green arrow at the side here, or you've spelled something wrong, capitalize a few letters wrong, all that stuff. So what we're going to basically do is we're going to, in our update entity, we're going to update the connections array. Now, of course, you don't need to do this all the time. You only need to do this whenever you update a block. But we're lazy people. I have a fast computer. I don't like seeing a difference. No drop in FPS. So we're just going to go with it. If not, if you have bad computers and you feel it's a, you know, it's a difference, then let me know. I don't think it's a difference. Just a note. Updating all the time. But let's do the updating all the time. Public void update connections. What we're basically going to do is we're going to say this dot update connections is basically going to update the connections quite simply. And what you should have, just so you note, you should have all of these in methods. That's object oriented programming. I have no idea what it's called. But it's basically make sure to have one method for every single thing you do, so that kind of other people reading this can do the same stuff. So people using your mod as an API can kind of course we're not creating an API here, but then people can read, just call that method right there without problems, instead of having to recreate the code. So one simple method and you are done. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to say if statement, if, and then we're going to say this dot world object dot get tile entity at x chord, y chord, and z chord instance of tile entity pipe. Then we are going to say connections 0 is equal to forge direction dot up. So what we're basically going to say here is basically going to say up. We're now defining like position 0 is up, position 1 is down, 2 is north, for example, 3 is east, for example, and then you have south and west in the end here. So number 0 is up. Now else connections 0 is equal to null. Now it's probably smarter to like make an API for this. If we're going to make like a full blown system, that's what I did for the Adexia mod. We don't have that time though. But what we're going to do is we're going to change all of this to 1. We're just going to make, change these to all of the numbers from 0 to 5 here as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, of course, this position right here is going to be the tile entity pipe. It's not going to be the block above. So to grab the block above, say plus 1, quite simple. What we're basically doing right here is we're basically checking, is this a tile entity pipe? Then, is there a tile entity pipe above us? Then set connections equal to up. There is a tile entity pipe above us. Next one, as you can see in our list here, is down. So let's say down. down, as you probably know, is one block minus on the y. The next one here is north. North, I think, I'm not quite sure. Let's actually launch up Minecraft here while we're working at it, because now we've pretty much created all our methods. So let's see north. I think north is set. North is set negative, okay. North set negative 1. Then we have east. East, let's check east. I think this right here is east. Yes, it is. That is set plus and x plus. So x plus 1 is east. Then we have south. South is plus 1 on the set. And west is minus 1 on the x. So this should now update the connections array every single tick. There's 20 ticks. 20 ticks. Basically, there is 20 ticks each second. I'm not receiving any like large FPS loss here. I'm horrible. I have horrible FPS while I'm recording because I'm not using a program to record gameplay here. So it's kind of messing up my frame rate a little bit. But we are at 40 frames is like doable, playable. So as you can see, we have these connections. It's only drawing one direction. One direction jokes, haha. But what we are going to do is we're going to say we're always, at the moment at least, going to draw the core. So let's actually open this up, just so we have a little bit clearer point of view here. We're always going to draw the core. Then we are going to say though, title entity pipe, and then pipe is equal to tile entity, because we know that the tile entity, because we kind of know that this tile entity right here is basically a part of the tile entity pipe. That's what we're rendering out. Let's see, integer I is equal to 0. I is less than pipe. Pipe dot connections dot length I plus plus. We're going to say if, ending it off quickly here, if pipe connections I is not equal to null, this basically means you have connected this way, then please draw connector, probably again spelled wrong, connector over pipe dot connections I. Okay, that should draw out a connection, no crash, and as you can see, they are successfully connecting towards each other. Now the thing is, if we draw them all in a line like this, we don't want boxes all along the way. We want this to kind of be one smooth thingy here. So what we do have to do is we have to draw straight. So we have to draw this thing right here, kind of straight. That's something we are going to do. I see that the texture is a little bit messed up here. Do the textures for yourself, you know, directions, stuff like that. This is just a way to set it up. I don't care too much about the color, I guess. If you are like, if you want to be like a real modder, then you should know how to do this yourself. I've explained it so many times in every single video I make. I'll have to end it here though. Next time we're going to move on to having like a big line instead. So hope you kind of going to enjoy that as well. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, everybody. My name is Scratchfan, and I'll catch you all guys in my next video. Goodbye, and have a nice day.